Hi, I am Dr. Hanjavam Barun Sharma, senior resident in the Department of Physiology, AIIMS, New Delhi. In this module, I will be talking about defibrillator. At the end of the modules, the students should be able to know about sudden cardiac death and cardiac arrest, know about electrical counter-shock therapy and defibrillation, including the mechanism behind. What defibrillators are, the common types and their workings. What automated external defibrillator or AED is, what the steps of defibrillation are and the possible complications. Know about implantable cardioverter defibrillators or ICD and wearable cardioverter defibrillator or WCD, sudden cardiac death and cardiac arrest. It is a natural death due to cardiac causes heralded by abrupt loss of consciousness within 1 hour of the onset of acute symptoms in an individual who may have known pre-existing heart diseases but in whom the time and mode of death are unexpected. Sudden cardiac death or SCD is a direct consequence of cardiac arrest. Cardiac arrest is the abrupt cessation of cardiac pump function, which may be reversible by a prompt intervention. The most common electrical mechanism for cardiac arrest is ventricular fibrillation or VF, sudden cardiac arrest, importance of defibrillation. Defibrillation and high quality and effective cardiopulmonary resuscitation or CPR are the most important initial treatments for sudden cardiac arrest or SCA. The time interval between cardiac arrest and defibrillation is the single most major factor on which survival of the patient depends. Survival decreases by 10% per minute when defibrillation is delayed in absence of CPR and 3-4% per minute with effective CPR. Electrical counter-shock therapy and defibrillation. Electrical counter-shock therapy involves delivery of a quantity of electrical energy to depolarize the myocardium so as to terminate a tachyarrhythmia. Defibrillation is an example of electrical counter-shock therapy. Since there is no relationship between the current delivery and the cardiac output, defibrillation is also called unsynchronized counter-shock or asynchronous counter-shock. Defibrillation was demonstrated for the first time in 1899. Defibrillation mechanism behind. Defibrillation involves delivery of uniform, strong and sufficient electrical energy to depolarize large majority of myocardium including fibrillating cells and at the same time briefly stunning the heart. If a sufficient portion of cardiac tissue were met temporarily unexcitable by a shock, the uncoordinated wave fronts of excitation that perpetuate ventricular fibrillation would be extinguished. When the cells repolarize, the pacemaker with the highest degree of automaticity should pace the heart. This would allow normal cardiac excitation and contraction to resume. The current should, however, be such that minimal or no myocardial damage is there. Defibrillators. It is a device which is used to deliver a shock to eliminate an abnormal heart rhythm. Common types of defibrillator currently in use are manual external defibrillator, automated external defibrillator or AED, implantable cardioverter defibrillator or ICD, and wearable cardioverter defibrillator or WCD, etc. Figure 1. External defibrillator. Defibrillator, the working. Defibrillator, in this case AED, contains a battery which is capable of storing a large amount of energy, but the storage is at energy levels that are too low to defibrillate. The capacitor of the defibrillator stores energy at a high enough to deliver sufficient current for defibrillation. Switching circuitry releases the energy stored in the battery to the capacitor and then applies it to the patient's chest in the appropriate time sequence, creating a specific waveform. The current is delivered to the patient using handheld pedals, which require conductive media or using combination pads or adhesive pads. There is ECG monitoring also. Defibrillation may be done as per the need. Defibrillator, the working. The shocks used for defibrillation are expressed in joules or J of energy. The current passes through the heart in waveforms. The waveforms may be monophasic, biphasic, and triphasic. Very few monophasic defibrillators are in use today, in which the current passes through the heart in one direction. With biphasic waveforms, the current moves in one direction for a specific period, stops, and then passes through the heart in the opposite direction during a very short period, say few milliseconds. Most of the current defibrillator use biphasic waveforms. Triphasic and quadriphasic waveform defibrillators deliver multidirectional shocks. For monophasic defibrillator, generally 360 joule is used for all shocks. For biphasic defibrillators, the energy levels used for initial and subsequent shocks are usually 120 to 200 joule. If the recommended energy levels are not known, then consider defibrillation at the maximal dose. Advantage of biphasic defibrillators. There is compensation for transthoracic impedance or TI. Body weight does not influence energy delivered. Low risk for thermal burns and potential myocardial damage due to lower total energy involved. Smaller and lighter device with extended battery life. Pedals or pads positioning is less of an issue. Removal of excessive hair and drying of wet and sweaty chest with a towel decreases transthoracic impedance. This should not delay defibrillation. Conductive gels decreases transthoracic impedance while using handheld pedals. The use of improper media or even excessive use of gel may cause arching and burns. It is to be noted that ultrasonographic gel is non-conductive. Optimum pedal or pad size varies as per patient's age, weight, and manufacturer. The adult size ranges from 8 to 12 cm. The use of pediatric electrodes should be avoided in adults for fear of myocardial injury. No alcohol or alcohol-based cleansers, tinctures of benzoin, or antiperspirant should be used for cleaning skin before applying pedals or pads. Saline shock gauze or alcohol shock pads should be avoided. This is done to avoid sparks and burns. The most common pedals or pads position is sternum apex position or anterolateral or apex anterior. In this, the sternum pedal or pads is placed lateral to the right side of the sternum just below the clavicle. The center of the left or apex pedal or pad is placed in the mid-axillary line below and lateral to left nipple or lateral and below left breast in females to reduce transthoracic impedance. Positioning choice is not so important when biphasic waveform devices are used. A firm pressure of about 11.3 kg is applied on each pedal when using handheld pedals in adult to lower the transthoracic impedance. Figure 2, position of electrodes or pads, that is anterolateral during defibrillation using external defibrillator. Automated external defibrillator or AED. It is an external defibrillator with a computerized cardiac rhythm analysis system. There are voice prompts and visual indicators which guide the user, making it very easy to use with little or even no training. Cardiac rhythm is examined and analyzed by the machine itself automatically. AED will signal everyone to stand clear of the patient and a shock is delivered via adhesive pads applied to the patient's chest. Figure 3. Semi-automated external defibrillators. In the event of sudden cardiac arrest, defibrillation has to be coordinated with high-quality CPR. The chest is exposed, optimal size pedals patch selected and positioned appropriately. Turn on the power to the defibrillator and verify the presence of a shockable rhythm. Select an appropriate energy level and deliver the shock as per the need after making sure that all are clear of the patient. There should not be any oxygen flow over the patient's chest for fear of possibility of ignition. Defibrillation, the steps. In case of AED, ECG rhythm is automatically analyzed. If shockable rhythm is found, the machine will signal via voice prompts that a shock is indicated and to be clear of the patients. The shock is delivered by the operator when hinted to do so by AED, that is in semi-automated, after everyone is clear of the patient. The fully automated device delivers the shock after signaling everyone to stand clear of the patient. Chest compressions of CPR should be minimally interrupted and be continued while the machine is charging. The rhythm is rechecked after 5 cycles of CPR. One cycle consists of 30 chest compression and 2 breaths, or 2 minutes as prompted by the AED. Defibrillation, the steps. If a shockable rhythm is present, a shock is delivered as above. Immediately after the shock, or in case of non-shockable rhythm detection, CPR is continued for another 2 minutes, with rechecking the rhythm every 2 minutes. The cycle is repeated till advanced life support or ALS is available, or the victim starts to move. Figure 4. Use of an AED on an adult patient. Slide number 5. CPR coordinating with an AED in a patient of sudden cardiac arrest. Complications of defibrillation and cardioversion. Skin burns and risk of ignition, myocardial damage or dysfunction, embolic episodes, cardiac dysrhythmia like asystole, atrioventricular block, bradycardia, ventricular fibrillation after cardioversion. There is also chance of injury to the operator or other rescue team members if proper techniques are not used. Implantable cardioverter defibrillators or ICD. ICD capable of detecting and terminating ventricular fibrillation are commonly used in patients at high risk for sudden cardiac death. Common types include transvenous ICD and subcutaneous ICD or SICD. The usual location of transvenous ICD is in subclavicular region and that of SICD is in mid-axillary line between the 5th and 6th intercostal spaces. Transvenous ICD is associated with higher risk of infection and lead-related complications as compared to SICD. However, SICD does not provide bradycardia or anti-tachycardia pacing. Figure number 6. Implantable cardioverter defibrillator or ICD. ICD can deliver cold tire therapy, defibrillation, anti-tachycardia, overdrive, pacing, synchronous cardioversion and bradycardia pacing based on the dysrhythmia detected and manner in which the device is programmed. Tire therapy is designed in such a way that increasing levels of intensity is used to terminate ventricular dysrhythmia. Example of 3 level of therapy is pacing, cardioversion and high energy defibrillation. ICD may deliver up to 6 shocks in ventricular fibrillation. Use of defibrillator in patient having ICD. If an ICD is in process of delivering shocks, AED is attached after 30 to 60 seconds so as to allow ICD treatment cycle to complete. Defibrillator pedals or combination pads are not to be placed over ICD. Ideally, at least 8 cm or 3 inches or at least 4 finger breadths should be there between the pedals or pads and the implanted device. Pulse generator. After defibrillation is done, ICD or the permanent pacemaker should be checked as defibrillation current flows may cause malfunction. Wearable cardioverter defibrillator or WCD. WCD is basically designed for long-term monitoring, detection of sudden cardiac arrest and shock delivery. This is without a need for bystander assistance or an implanted device to bridge an assessment period or to let optimal medical therapy deliver its benefit. WCD consists of an ECG monitoring system and an external automatic defibrillator. It is usually used when there is high arrhythmic risk for a limited period as for transient causes for reduction in left ventricular ejection fraction as a bridge to an ICD or cardiac transplantation, etc. Slide number 28. A wearable cardioverter defibrillator or WCD. Summary. Cardiac arrest and sudden cardiac death are major problems worldwide. The most common electrical mechanism for cardiac arrest is ventricular fibrillation. Defibrillation and high quality and effective CPR are the most important initial treatments. The time interval between cardiac arrest The time interval between cardiac arrest and defibrillation is the single most major factor on which survival of the patient depends. Defibrillation involves delivery of an electric current across the myocardium over a very brief period to depolarize in order to terminate an abnormal heart rhythm or convert back into normal sinus rhythm. The device which delivers the shock to eliminate an abnormal heart rhythm is called defibrillator. The shocks used are expressed in joules of energy. The current passes through the heart in waveforms and may be monophasic, biphasic, and triphasic depending upon whether the current flow delivered is in one direction, two directions, or multiple directions. Most of the current defibrillators use biphasic waveforms. The energy used in monophasic devices is generally 360 joule for all shocks. Biphasic defibrillator uses 120 to 200 joules for the initial and subsequent shocks. Some of the common types of defibrillators currently in use are manual external defibrillator, automated external defibrillator or AED, implantable cardioverter defibrillator or ICD, wearable cardioverter defibrillator or WCD, etc. AED is an external defibrillator with a computerized cardiac rhythm analysis system. There are voice prompts and visual indicator which guide the user through a series of steps that may include defibrillation, making it very easy to use with little or even no training. The procedure for defibrillation, in this case AED, include applying adhesive patch over patient's bare chest in the recommended position, example, anterolateral. AED automatically analyzes ECG rhythm, and if shockable rhythm is found, signals that a shock is indicated. It delivers the required shock after the operator presses the shock control. In a fully automated version, the machine delivers the shock by itself, with confirming that all members are clear of the patient. In case of cardiac arrest with possibility of sudden cardiac death, defibrillation is coordinated with CPR with minimally interruption in the chest compression. After every 5 cycles of CPR or 2 minutes, cardiac rhythm checking is done and shock is delivered if indicated. This is continued till advanced life support or ALS is available or the victim starts to move. The possible complications of external defibrillation and cardioversion may include burns, myocardial damage, embolic episodes, dysrhythmias like asystole, atrioventricular block, bradycardia, and even ventricular fibrillation, etc. Implantable cardioverter defibrillators or ICD are capable of detecting and terminating ventricular fibrillation and commonly used in patients at high risk for sudden cardiac death. Common types include transvenous ICD and subcutaneous ICD or SICD. There is more risk of infection and other lead-related complications in transvenous ICD than in SICD. But SICD does not provide bradycardia or anti-tachycardia pacing. Wearable cardioverter defibrillator or WCD is usually used when there is high arrhythmic risk for a limited period, as for transient causes for reduction in left ventricular ejection fraction, and as a bridge to an ICD or cardiac transplantation, etc. Thank you.